been sitting here staring at the clock on the wall. And I've been laying here praying, praying he won't call. It's just another call from home, and you'll get it and be gone, and I'll be crying.
Definitely, it allowed me to stand back and look at my career outside, you know, from, you know, someone else's point of view. You know, as a judge on X Factor, you feel like a one-man record company. You know, you're picking the songs, you're picking the outfits, marketing, your sales team, you're everything all in one team, one person. And that's helped me greatly with my own career. It would be great to be back in, you know, Europe, to be close to the kids. It's hard being so far from them. You know, it's a 23-hour flight from Dublin to Sydney, and you know, it's hard on the kids, and you know, I miss them a lot, so that would help. It's changed so much, and I know you can, I can harp on about it and sound, I'll sound like a broken record, but really, I mean, now music, we release our albums so that we can go on tour. That's really what happens, because of the situation with the music industry and how dwindling album sales and so on for all artists across the globe, except for those one or two lucky ones like Adele, who just breaks all the records. Everybody else is, you know, in a different place than we were like 20 years ago. I'd sell 1 million records in the UK, you'd sell 250,000 now. I mean, that's how it's changed, that's how much it's changed. But I'm lucky that I can still tour. So that's really what we do. You make music and you release it, you get it on the radio so that you have the opportunity to go back on, you know, do live shows. So I'm lucky now that I can go on the road in January, February, March, April of next year and tour Europe and Australia, and hopefully do some dates here in Asia. I have the best job in the world. I don't really have a problem with any of it, to be honest. I'm very lucky. I could say, you know, that touring is my favorite, but I don't have any bad. There's no bad stuff. I've been away from the kids for a long time. When you're traveling, it can be difficult. Yeah. Yeah, if I had to pick something. Yeah, I think all of us as artists, really, that's why we cling on. You know, that's the most enjoyable part of the job. I love it. Getting up on stage and performing and, you know, traveling around, meeting people, different cities, singing the songs, watching people sing them back to you, just doing what we're supposed to do, really, yeah. I remember walking out on stage in Berlin was it the European Championships? The World Cup. The World Cup, was it? 500,000 people in front of me, it was ridiculous. And that was the largest live concert I'd ever put on. That was pretty amazing. I'll never forget that moment. That, you know, the hair stood up in my arms, it was incredible. Funny, I have seen that, and they now come to the gigs with their kids, and it's like, what the, you know? And I've watched these guys and girls growing up, and you know, they've stood beside me and asked for autographs when I was 16, and now here they are coming to the gigs, and they're, you know, singing along to the lyrics with their kids with them. Like, it's incredible, you know? I feel very lucky that they've stayed that loyal, and that they've stuck with me, you know, through thick and thin. So next time you find I think you need to do that every now and then, and you know, you try different things. Sometimes they work, sometimes they don't. I've done it, I've gone and made mistakes, but I think you do need to be adventurous. I think it's good to do it. I think you challenge yourself by doing that, and it helps you to move forward. I needed optimism, I needed hope. When you've caused a lot of pain and hurt in people's lives, you know, that you feel you're at rock bottom and that you feel pretty worthless. And, you know, you need hope, you know, you need optimism to get you out of those holes. It was friendship that definitely got me through it, yeah. The most personal track, there's a song called Easy Now My Dear, which is a song about calm, about finding solace in your life. And I think we all should find a little bit of that. I do, I need to, I needed to, and I did. So yeah, calm is important. We live in a crazy life world, should I say, you know, with cell phones and Facebook and Twitter, and everything is so fast and so quick and so immediate, and it's like, wow, when do we stop? You know, you can't even go away on holidays now without constantly being on your laptop or on your phone. And you know, I sometimes I just have to get on an airplane and go long haul somewhere to stop doing anything. Because I have to turn off my phone and turn off, you know, I read a book and I just sit there, it's great, and I don't feel guilty that I'm not in contact with people. So for me, it's that's what this song is about. I'm banging on doors trying to make that happen. You have no idea how difficult it is to put a team together and how expensive. And it's obviously, you know, a lot of people die every year climbing Everest, so it's huge insurance risks. But I would like to think by 2014 that would be something I'd be seriously in the middle of making happen. Yeah, I want to do it. So if anyone out there in Singapore has a lot of money that want to climb Everest, give me a shout. I'll do it with you. With great difficulty. It's very, very, very tough. And sometimes things get missed because of it, you know, you let things slip. I am trying my best to juggle all of these different items in the air. I've got a lot of balls in the air right now and I'm juggling them all. It's a lot of fun and I have a lot of energy. I do have a lot of fire in my belly and I'm excited to be back doing it. But I'm trying not to spread myself too thin, because that's the mistake you can make. Everything that I do, I'd like to give it 100%. So I'm trying to just balance that out at the moment. But you know, life is wonderful. I feel lucky. I feel blessed. Back on my feet again and back with this record. Greatest personal achievement would be my children, definitely my three kids. In my career, getting the chance to work with Cat Stevens was a big deal for me. And I guess singing with Elton was pretty amazing too. And Pavarotti. Oh, wow. Well, I'd like to be remembered for being a good dad, a good man. Made people happy with my music, it'd be nice.